Do-do-do-do-do. Oh my god. Oh my god. Can you believe this air-powered muscle was made in just 10 minutes with this small machine right here on my left? In this video, let's take a closer look at this beast. Yes, this beast is called Swordigator. It's the world's first desktop software injection molding machine. With it, you can produce just about anything your imagination allows, like face blades in different colors, shapes, and hardness levels. Perfect for anglers, or for dedicated makers and designers like I showed at the beginning, air-powered grippers for your robotic arm. All you need is to print a mold using your 3D printer and start producing whatever you want. Most importantly, this machine is extremely affordable and beginner friendly. Even for someone using it for the first time, there's basically zero learning curve. Unboxing! All right, out of the box, we have the face. Wow, that is small, super portable. I can just hold it with one hand easily. And then we have the injection chamber. Okay, we'll take a look at it a little bit later. No worries about it. Obviously, we have the power adapter and two clamps. And that's basically everything in the box. Oh, by the way, just a second. Don't forget, we have one bottle of raw material, which, you know, comes with the box, but in a separate box. So that's the unboxing. Now let's assemble it. First, make sure the valve and injection chamber is closed. You'll see two gears here. Just twist them slightly to make sure the teeth are misaligned, like shown in the video. Under the bottom of the chamber, there are charging contacts. Just align them with the contact pins and the base. That's it. This may be the easiest assembly I've ever done in a tech review. Remove the handle, and now you can pour in some raw material from the bottle. Make sure not to exceed the max fill length to avoid overflow. As I said earlier, you can get creative, add whatever color pigments you like. Put the handle back on, plug in the machine, and turn it on. There's more display at the front. It lights up and it shows both the target and current temperature. Let's set the temperature to 108 degrees Celsius and press the middle button to confirm. You'll see the temperature gradually rise. Remember, the raw material we poured in was white, right? Now it slowly turns transparent. During the entire heating process, you don't need to do anything. Just wait until it reaches the set temperature. It usually takes only around 10 minutes, super fast. Now we can finally remove the chamber and begin the injection process. Rotate the gears to align the teeth to open the valve. Squeeze a little magic gel out first to ensure the flow is smooth and the nozzle isn't clogged. Now align the nozzle with your mold and inject. Try to inject as quickly as possible so the gel doesn't start solidifying during the process. Even if you're clumsy like me and accidentally overfill the mold, it's no big deal. The excess gel is very easy to clean and won't stick to the mold or the table. And of course, remember to close the valve after the injection. Now for the mold filled with the gel. All you need to do is crack it open and take the final product out. The whole process feels like peeling an eggshell. Weirdly satisfying. As for the molds themselves, the official store provides many designs, and you can also 3D print your own. There are tons of websites with great templates available. Over the past few days, just for fun, I made tons of cool little molded toys with it. Check them out. So yeah, after spending the past few days getting hands-on with the Swordigator, I can honestly say this is one of the most fun and practical desktop machines I've tested in a long time. When I first saw this kind of mold machine, I seriously doubted whether it might release some nasty fumes or be unsafe to use. But in reality, the fully enclosed chamber ensures that even in a relatively sealed studio environment, there's no odor and no safety concerns at all. And the whole process? Super straightforward. Whether you're a hardcore angler making custom baits, a maker designing soft touch components, or just someone who enjoys experimenting with new materials, Swordigator opens up a whole new world of soft plastic modeling right from your desktop. It heats up in minutes, works with a wide range of materials and 3D printed molds, and the whole process is clean, safe, and beginner friendly. And the fact that you can reuse leftover material to total game changer. Most importantly, it solves a lot of the pain points traditional soft plastic workflows cannot. It's compact, affordable, efficient, and honestly, just really satisfying to use. This isn't a toy or novelty, it's a real tool for creators. And if you already own a 3D printer, this is the perfect companion to take your prototyping to the next level. Blend your hard and soft components seamlessly. Surrogate might be small, but packs a ton of power and potential. So if you're interested in a product that can seriously level up your creative workflow, check out the link in the description. I'm back now on Kickstarter. Thanks for watching. I'm Samuel. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.